The other day I saw a 5-year-old boy who was transferred to the emergency department with the diagnosis of an incarcerated hernia. They had presented to a peripheral hospital and already received a comprehensive ultrasound with radiology, which confirmed the diagnosis. Unfortunately, it was a particularly busy day in our emergency department, and the child was not in a room until about 5 or 6 hours when I saw them. Because it had been out for so long, I was quite concerned, and I brought in with me intranasal midazolam, intranasal fentanyl, in anticipation that I would quickly sedate the child and try to reduce the hernia. But when I went into the room, and before I gave the medications, I had a quick look at the site, and it really didn't appear to be an incarcerated hernia, at least compared to previous patients I had seen with the same diagnosis. And so I brought the ultrasound machine in and I had a quick look. And what I saw were large lymph nodes, in fact. No abscess was found, but they were quite inflamed. And what I also noted on the skin were several old scab lesions. And they were all over the body. And when I spoke to mom, I found out the child had actually just gotten over a bout of chicken pox, but had been scratching furiously. And if you actually looked at the whole clinical picture, the area was quite tender, it was slightly red, it was swollen, and he barely tolerated the ultrasound itself. I guess the take home here is that you should always look with the ultrasound before you perform any procedure, whether it's the reduction of an incarcerated hernia or IND of an abscess, especially when you didn't make the diagnosis yourself previously. And this can save you lots of hassle and discomfort or unnecessary sedations for your patient.